Hello everyone, today I will mainly demonstrate how to use the Antminer ASIC Repair Tester. First, I will introduce the Antminer ASIC Repair Tester and other tools that need to be used in the process of using the fixture. Open the box, we can see the materials contained in the tester. 12 volts power plug, and the cable. One end is connected to the socket, and the other end is connected to the test fixture. Data cable, used to connect the test fixture and hash board. Brand new Antminer ASIC repair tester. It can test the ASIC chip and temperature sensor chip on the hash board, and can also program EEPROM file. Multimeter, mainly used to test the voltages of the hash board. Adjustable voltage power supply, which can be used to power the hash board. During the test, we need to set the voltage of the PSU to the corresponding input voltage of the test hash board. Next, we start setting up the test fixture. Before using the fixture to test the hash board, we need to set the network frequency band of the test fixture and computer to be consistent, so that the fixture can start to work normally. Power on the tester first. Insert this end into the tester, and the other end into the socket, and then wait for the tester to start. Well, the tester has been started. Attention, the IP address displayed on the fixture screen needs to be remembered. We need to use this address to set the network frequency band. Then the computer network chooses to connect to ASIC tester. After the connection is successful, enter the IP address 192.168.4.1 in the browser, and select the network used by the computer to connect. As you can see, the test fixture is reconnecting. Similarly, we need to remember the IP address 192.168.50.177 displayed on the test fixture, and enter this address on the computer. Okay, the connection is successful. When this interface appears, it means that our test fixture has been connected. Let me introduce the function keys on the test fixture for you. This black rotary button is mainly used to select the model of the hash board to be tested. What we need to test today is the S17E hash board, so it can be adjusted to S17E here. In addition, we can also choose the model of the hash board on the computer. Okay, the introduction is complete. Let's demonstrate how to use the ASIC repair tester. First, use the data cable to connect the hash board and the test fixture. Then clip the positive and negative clips of the power cord to the hash board. Special attention must be paid to not being reversed. After the connection is complete, turn on the voltage regulating PSU, and set the voltage to the 18 volts input voltage of the S17E hash board. Okay, click the test button here to start testing. If 135 is displayed on the fixture screen, it means that a total of 135 ASIC chips have been found. It can be seen from the display on the computer that chips from number 1 to number 135 are all okay, which means that the hash board is normal. Next, we use a multimeter to test the total domain voltage. Adjust the multimeter to the DC voltage gear, and then press the red button on the test fixture, so that there will be voltage output. It can be seen that the multimeter shows a voltage of about 18 volts. During the test, if the voltage output time ends, we need to press the button again, which will make it easier for us to test the relevant voltage of the hash board. Now I will demonstrate and test the temperature sensor chip on the hash board for everyone. Click here on the computer display interface to start the test. Okay, the test passed. Here are the ASIC chips corresponding to the four temperature sensing chips on the hash board, which are number 28, number 36, number 108, and number 100 chips. Finally, we demonstrate the writing of EEPROM chip files. First, select the hash board model, then click EEPROM Write to start writing the file. When the progress bar on the test fixture interface reaches 100%, it means that the EEPROM file has been written. Well, the above is the specific method of using the Antminer ASIC repair tester. Thank you all.